Rob Thummel joins us now to talk more about what lies ahead for the oil market in 2020. He's a portfolio manager at Tortoise Advisors. Good to see you. Thanks for joining us tonight.
Thanks, Bill.
And actually, you think that 2020 will mark a return for the U.S. energy sector. What do you mean?
Well, as Brian and others have talked about, you know, the last decade was a bad one for the energy sector. But going forward, we see a lot of opportunities and catalysts for the energy sector. The biggest one is what Brian highlighted. The U.S. is now a net energy exporter. Mm-hmm. So going forward in the next decade, 2020 and beyond, there's a significant opportunity for investors to capitalize on the opportunity in the U.S. as the U.S. becomes a large supplier of all energy commodities to the rest of the world.
Do you see prices going higher, and who will set those prices? Is that still OPEC that has the power to do that, or does the U.S. industry have the power now?
Well, going forward, oil will still remain relevant and somewhat important, but natural gas and renewables actually will be the opportunity going forward. But specific to your question, from an oil price perspective, we have got plenty of supply. OPEC is still important, but the U.S. will also play a critical role there as well. But for the energy sector to be successful, this is the most important part of it. We just need stable oil prices, stable energy prices. And we think the setup is pretty strong for the next decade to have stable, consistent energy prices, which then allow a lot of the companies and the cash flows that they're generating to continue to grow. And that's what investors will reward going forward.
Your three winners, the stocks you like for next year, why those three in particular?
Yeah, so energy infrastructure is a place here at Tortoise that we really love for a lot of reasons. First of all, energy is essential. And if you're going to transport energy, if the U.S. is going to export more energy, we need more energy infrastructure. We need existing infrastructure to facilitate that export growth going forward that's going to happen in 2020 and beyond. So companies like Enterprise Products, that pays a dividend yield of almost 6.5%, owns critical energy infrastructure, have raised their dividend for over a decade every single year. Right. Other companies like Williams Companies, once again, another 6.5% dividend yielder. Magellan Midstream, another 6.5% dividend yielder. Investors really, from our perspective, Bill, are starving for yield. You know, the S&P 500 yields 1.9%, the 10-year Treasury yields 1.8%. You need dividend yields as an investor, and we think energy infrastructure is a great place to find some of those dividend yields.
By the way, quickly, you mentioned natural gas. Prices have floundered for a number of years because of an oversupply. Do you see that ending at some point?
Well, first of all, natural gas is probably one of the most critical commodities going forward. We need to lower carbon emissions basically globally, right? And the playbook in the U.S., and not a lot of people know this, but carbon emissions in the U.S. have declined in the last 10 years. One of the reasons for that is because of the increased use of natural gas in the electricity sector to generate electricity. So that needs to be applied globally, and it will be in the next decade. And if we apply the same formula in the U.S. globally in the next decade and eliminate coal and increase natural gas and renewables, we'll end up reducing carbon emissions globally. And so we think natural gas plays a really critical role. The price can stay low, and that actually will boost demand going forward.
Very good. Rob Thummel with Tortoise Advisors. Again, thanks for joining us tonight, Rob.
Thank you, Bill.